Hello everyone, I hope all is well and thanks for joining me. I want to welcome you to the space that has been created by me with the help of my wife. Of course, she gave me this wonderful relaxation chair for relaxing and doing my videos. So I think it's important to always have the flexibility to record outside, inside, on stage, and just to be there. And let me tell you, I enjoy doing this, and that is why it never seems like work. Now, I want to bring you to a critical point of reflection. Recently, we have seen where people are talking about the hurricanes and that these hurricanes have been a result of human intervention. Yes, climate change is an aspect of human intervention. As a matter of fact, some people have stated that this hurricane season has been as a result of humans creating these hurricanes. Yes, and as a matter of fact, there are several videos out there circulating that is articulating this thought, and others are believing. And this issue is problematic because it shows that the population is lacking in some form of critical thinking. And that's why I want to go back to revisit Finland. Finland is a place that I've studied over the years. In England, I studied this country and other Scandinavian countries in relation to the education system they offer. And of course, their education system is top class. And I think the West at some point needs to reflect on what Finland is doing. Now, how did I get my information? Let me tell you that part of my journey is to educate myself. And I subscribe to many journals privately and also to newspapers. And this one, I came across this when I read my New York Times digital paper most recently. So I wanted to share this information with you because I think it's important for us to get critically engaged in what's happening. Now, here's where it starts. And the presentation is entitled, How Finland is Leading the Fight Against Misinformation and Lessons That We in the Western World and Other Countries Need to Understand. In today's digital world, I want to say that there's a spread of misinformation that is growing worldwide. As I stated earlier in the video, we saw where there is confirmation about people talking about certain things that have been created by man that has upbeated these hurricanes. Now, Finland, however, stands out globally. Its early years development programs must be considered as one of the best. And Finland has an innovative approach. And this is key to the success of tackling misinformation. And in this presentation, I want to highlight how they are doing it, because I think that is so important for us to understand that. Just imagine, if we are not able to tackle misinformation, our world will be in crisis. Our political systems will die because we need individuals with critical thinking to navigate the world. Now, let me say that Finland's approach to misinformation is success, starting with preschool. Notice, it starts with preschool. We get students to think critically about what they are seeing. And in preschool, they start by thinking about media literacy, and it is a part of the national curriculum. Now, I've always talked about critical literacy and the need to engage critical literacy at an early stage. And I think Finland might not have been calling it critical literacy as connected to Pablo Ferreira's role in that field, but they have given their preschoolers the tools necessary to start off. Now, teachers have interactive lessons in Finland that they teach children and students how to critically evaluate articles, videos, and of course, social media content. In the West, we seem to have not engaged as much in that area. By engaging students at this early age, they are able to discuss things about the reliability of the information. And of course, at the early stage, they understand that things can be fabricated. Yes, Finland ensures that its youths are equipped with the tool to spot misinformation. And in our Western society, I'm seeing the problem that we can't even spot it sometimes. The reality is that we have not taught this level of education, and it's important more so in the pathway as we are moving towards artificial intelligence. Let's say, for instance, in one lesson, TikTok is used to help an 8th grader understand how they can be manipulated by influencers are, of course, and how these influences can influence their perspectives. Now, one key thing in getting people to understand this, and even 8th graders in Finland, is for them to understand that there must be a motive for what the content is being designed for. And they must understand the motive and, of course, the context of the content. In our Western society, we seldomly think critically, that's some people that is, about the motive behind why certain things are being produced. No, as I stated before, I have engaged in critical literacy studies. My doctorate is in language and literacy. I know the power of language. I know the power of literacy. Language has the power to create and also the power to destroy. Now, the important thing is to understand media literacy. Now, if I go back to my thoughts regarding new literacy studies that I studied back in UK, and of course, Brian Street, the founder of that, he really stressed the importance of media literacy across subjects. And Finland has done a unique approach by integrating media literacy across the area in all subjects, physical education to mathematics. And let me say that Finland National Audiovisual Institute has pointed out that no matter what the teacher is teaching, you have to think, how do I include these elements in my work with children? That's a question that is being asked. When you think about this approach, it fosters critical thinking at all levels. And that is so important. Let us not forget that there is a purpose for critical thinking. As students navigate the complex media landscape of our world today, students need to question everything. Are you questioning everything that is produced, or you're accepting it? And that's what I realized, that even in academia today, I hear a lot of people talking. And when I asked them, where did they get it from? They said, I just made it up. It happens. And I say, where is your literature to back it up? They have none. So they are baseless. But students everywhere and learners need to question everything. From search engine results that we can see biases in consistently, especially for marginalized groups, to new stories that are being developed. This is the age of disinformation, and we must equip ourselves to deal with it. I am saying this because, you know what? Sometimes, if I'm not careful, I'll find myself in this pathway. So I'm saying this to you as you're listening. Consider these elements. Now, let me say that the impact of social media is growing. We have a crisis in the United States and several countries where TikTok has taken away the attention span of children to level it off at 15 seconds and 30 seconds. Now, I say we're going to need to have to work towards balancing that. Finland teachers are addressing this head on, whether by showing students how easy it is to edit a video they understand, or discussing how search algorithms influence results. And that is so important. We in the West have allowed these tech companies to push algorithms at us. And of course, these algorithms, sometimes we can classify them as being addictive. I'm not saying that all of the Western society have not been equipped with regards to misinformation, but I want to say that where we stand, there's a segment of our population that needs to be educated. And we can go back to Finland, where it all started from, because I don't think that we have the in-depth critical literacy or media literacy skills within the Western society. We have ran away from it for some reasons. But beyond the broader classroom in Finland, where schools focus on educating the youth, Finland also makes other extra efforts. Libraries are hubs as it relates for teaching the older generation. One of my particular fundamental eye-opening moment was when I went to Jamaica and I asked someone, do you know that this is not a real voice? And they could not tell if it was or wasn't. Therefore, we need to teach the older generation how to ensure that they can spot misinformation, to ensure that people, regardless of their age level, are ready to deal and address misinformation or misleading content. This is a community-wide approach that is necessary in modeling other nations grappling with this problem. And I see this as a great problem. I want to see that the world can look at Finland as a model. As a model as it relates to starting in the early years to develop that consciousness necessary to navigate the field of misinformation. As technology increases, we're going to find that we're going to have problems definitely dealing with these issues. And misinformation is becoming a fabric of our society. As individuals, I think it's important for us to really get adept into understanding the power of misinformation. Yes, it's powerful. I want to say it's a time for us to get on board and call for educators, government stakeholders, parents, to have this sort of media literacy in our schools worldwide. Because at this point, we're at a crossroad that we might not be able to navigate if our citizens are not globally ready to take on the mantle of examining misinformation at a level that they need to be able to. That's all for now. Remember to subscribe.